Welcome to the 45th World Artistic Gymnastic Championships from Nanning in southern China at the Wangxi Sports Complex. Day one of men's apparatus finals. Top eight gymnasts from qualification will compete on the floor, the pommel horse and the rings. There's our list of qualifiers. First up on the floor, from Russia, Denis ABLIAZIN. Powerful gymnast, Olympic bronze medalist, qualified in first place. The huge start score of 7-1. Been sent to these championships for Russia, somewhat of a specialist. Only competing on three apparatus. Has qualified in all of those finals. Super strong performer on the floor. Very dynamic, powerful. Good in the twisting combinations. Needs a big tumble to finish. Triple twist. Super start. Huge height in the twisting elements and the tumbling elements. 15.75, it's a massive score for ABLIAZIN. Into first place. Next, onto the floor from Brazil. 28 years of age, Diego HYPOLITO. Vast experience. Competed in two Olympic Games. Been world champion on the floor in 2005. And 2007, and see why. High into the combination. Qualified in third, a score of 15.9. If you could match that, it would go into first place. Nice twisting combination. Good control in the rollout. Sound signifies. Gymnast has 10 seconds to finish. Up into the triple twist. Small adjustment on landing. Got to be happy with that. Very difficult opening tumble, the double pike Arabian. Immediately into the tuck front somersault with full twist. Needs a big score. 15.7, it's big, but not big enough for HYPOLITO. Next on floor from Japan, Kenzo SHIRAI. The youngest competitor in this final, only 18 years of age, and is the defending world champion. Huge twisting combination in the first tumble, and again in the second. Qualified second, posted 16.033. By far The biggest start value difficulty, 7.4. Composure. Big in the twist, and again. The flag is raised. That will cost him 0.1. Another twist. The big final tumble. And it is big. Stands up. The quadruple twist. There's the fall. Wraps in there for the triple. 22 and a half twists within this routine. He is the king of the twisting. But that was the error. Stepping out the floor is 0.1. And it's been costly. 15.733. Puts him in second place so far. Next on the floor, Jacob Dalton of the USA. Big opening tumble. Has a bit of a pedigree on the floor. He was fifth in the final in 2012. And he took a silver last year. Can this be the year he becomes world champion? Needs to go above 15.75. to take the lead. Good control, slight adjustment on the landing. Final tumble for a world title. There's the buzzer, stands up, triple twist. Solid performance there, Jacob Dalton. Huge opening tumble. Double layout with the half twist. There's the 2.5 into the full. You will have to wait. How unfortunate, 15.6, just outside the medals, in fourth. So it's confirmed from Russia, Denis ABLIAZIN takes gold, 15.75. There's results, Denis ABLIAZIN takes the gold, Kenzo SHIRAI the silver from Japan, and bronze goes to Diego HYPOLITO from Brazil. ...2014 world champion on floor from Russia, Denis ABLIAZIN. Silver to Japan, Kenzo SHIRAI. And bronze to Brazil, Diego HYPOLITO. Next apparatus, the men's pommel horse final. There's the top eight qualifiers. In there, Krisztian BERKI, the Olympic champion. First up, from France, Cyril TOMMASONE. Second in 2011, fifth in 2012, qualified in fifth, with a score of 15.5, and going well so far. Must perform the double leg circle in a variety of positions, travelling along the horse like that. The turns build the difficulty. needs to keep the momentum, and he does. Slight hesitation on the dismount. Good start. Happy with that. Support from the French team as well. Good control in the handstand into the single leg work. Silver in 2011. Can he make it gold today? So far, so good. 15.6. Thomason from France into first place. Next from Croatia, Filip UDE, 28 years of age. His best result on the Pommel Horse was fifth in 2010. So he's desperate to win his first medal on this apparatus. Beautiful execution on the circles. Pirouettes in the handstand, keeps the momentum going. Qualified in fourth. Very difficult work between the handles. Extends and pushes, travels along the horse. And again with the turn. Super, super work. Keeps his momentum going. Up into the handstand, no hesitation there on the pirouette. Filip UDE from Croatia applies the pressure. There's a very difficult combination. There you can see between the handles, not much room for error. Will that be good enough to win his first ever world medal? He hopes so. Super lift into the dismount. No hesitation. The smile says it all. And so does the score. 15.783. Filip UDE goes into the lead on the pommels. Standing so far, UDE first, Thomason second, and Nador from the USA in third. Last to the Pommel Horse, Krisztian BERKI qualified in first. European champion, world champion in 2010, 2011, and the current Olympic champion. Super stylish start. Great separation in the single leg work. If anybody can push a 16 on this piece of apparatus, it's BERKI. Difficult work between the handles. Onto the end, travelling down the horse. Has the most difficult routine in this final, but he must complete it into the pirouette, and he does. Just look at the control at the start of the routine, the leg separation showing great flexibility. There's a difficult spin within the handles. Spindle on the end. The Hungarians have been masters of the Pommel Horse for such a long time. Follows a very long and strong tradition of Pommel Horse workers. turns in the pirouette with ease. Score comes in 16.033. Krisztian Berkey wins another world title on the pommel horse. Silver for Croatia's Filip UDE and bronze Cyril Thomason of France. ...2014 world champion on the pommel horse from Hungary, Krisztian Berkey. Filip UDE from Croatia takes the silver and Cyril Thomasone of France the bronze. The last apparatus, the men's rings, they're the eight qualifiers. Arthur Navarrete Zanetti, the defending champion and Olympic champion. First up though, from China, LIU Yang, qualified in first place with a massive 15.933. Just 20 years of age, was fourth in last year's World Championships. And be keen to build on that. Strong start. And watch this for strength. Pressing from below the rings, straight into the inverted crucifix. The judges look to see if the gymnasts hold the positions for 2 seconds. And flat in the inverted crucifix. Gymnasts must use swinging elements as well on this apparatus. And that's it. Swing up to handstand. Swing into the dismount. Full twist in double back straight. Nails the landing. That was something special. So flat on the Maltese. Perfect in the inverted crucifix. In the top plunge. There's the swinging element. Front somersault to crucifix. And still had enough energy. Kick high into the dismount. Spots the landing. Should be a good score. And it is. Same as qualification. 15.933. LIU Yang goes into the lead.
Next on the range from Brazil, Arthur Zanetti.
Pressure's on for the defending world champion, Olympic champion, Arthur Navarrete Zanetti from Brazil, qualified in fourth with 15.716. He knows he has it all to do. Strong start. Super control, super strength. Into the swinging elements. Back to strength. Into the swinging elements and to the crucifix. Shoulders level with the rings. That's what the judges are looking for. Up into the handstand. Needs a good dismount. Full twist in double straight. The tiniest of hops on landing. But this is powerful work. In the back punch, pressing back level to the Maltese. Locked out strong in the top plunge. That's the Honma, the front somersault to the crucifix. He needs to go above 15.933 if he wants to retain his title. .733, not just good enough today. In second, next up, Yu Hao from China. Big home support for the Chinese gymnast tonight. Qualified in seventh place with 15.633. This is his first World Championships rings final. He's got the difficulty. Impressive crucifix in the Russian lever position. Must swing up to handstand, lock it out. Double straight somersault between the rings. Unusual combination there with the leaning to seat a crucifix. Good original work. Up to handstand. Can he finish well? Winds up into the dismount. Huge double twisting, double straight. Punches the air. Super, super work. That's the back up rise into the Maltese. If anything, shoulders a little high. But that was much better. Needs to be flat with the rings. And the most difficult dismount we've seen so far. The double twist. 15.6 into third. He's looking slightly confused. There's the current leader, Liu Yang. And yes, inquiry submitted. That means if the coaches don't agree with what the judges have given him for the D score, which is difficulty, they can object. And it has been accepted. His D score has gone up. And so will his score. So he has a new score. You have 15.7, still in third. But that could make all the difference with one to go. From Russia, Denis ABLIAZIN. We've seen him just take gold on the floor. Such a powerful gymnast. Competed in the 2012 Olympics. Qualified for the rings final. Finished fifth. And is a current European champion on this piece of apparatus. High in the swinging elements, combined into the strength. Such control. And again. Qualified in second place with 15.866. Needs a solid dismount though. Good control in the long swing. Kicks up, huge dismount, double twisting, double straight. Well, ABLIAZIN responds. Locked out there in the top plunge. huge dismount. Very difficult double twisting, double straight. What's the score going to be? 15.7 for ABLIAZIN into third. We have a tie on the rings. But there's our champion from China, Liu Yang. First place, 15.933. World champion, yes you are, number one. And that's the standings, men's final results. Liu Yang, world champion, takes the gold. Silver, Arthur Nabarrete Zanetti from Brazil. And a bronze for China's Yu Hao, shared with Denis ABLIAZIN from Russia. ...2014 world champion on the rings from China, Liu Yang. Silver goes to Arthur Nabarrete Zanetti from Brazil, and a tie for the bronze, Yu Hao from China, Denis ABLIAZIN from Russia.